be helpful to you.
Yeah.
Right.
So in Mandarin at least it's 帮忙一下. And that gets
help
you,
a little.
Yeah, that gets you a long ways when you're friends.
Right.
You know, with okay. your suppliers.
Now, you're saying you've got 60, 70 great people working together and, you know, making this brand become a worldwide brand. Because your company is a cloud-based office, mm-hmm. right?
Right.
You actually work online, and that's how you connect these 70 people.
Right.
Does that mean you've got 70 people distributed all around the world?
Yes.
In major cities? They're all sent from here to those countries.
Two-thirds of those people are based in Taiwan. The other third are based overseas. So we have people in the United States spread in, again, in a couple of different cities. And we have people in Europe as well.
Just one to an office? One person to an office, almost? Since it's cloud-based, right?
Sometimes it is.
Okay.
If we have, you know, for example, our head designer is Finnish.
Yeah.
He's great, and he's based in his own private office in Finland. In the United States, we have people in their own individual offices, and we have, you know, in our distribution center, then we have multiple people together. China, the same thing. But it's pretty interesting because all of our, let's say, our project management software, service software, it's all based, as you mentioned, in the cloud. And so we develop a product, we make a drawing here, we go to sleep, and you know the guy in Europe comes on,
mm-hmm.
they work on the project, they go to sleep, and then the guys in the US take over. I think being kind of very much a global organization makes us very strong because you get a viewpoint which is international rather than local.
Mm-hmm.
You know, how a guy in Finland uses a bicycle is different from how a guy in Taiwan uses a bicycle. And that's different from how a guy in Austin, Texas uses a bicycle. And if you just have that one kind of viewpoint, it makes your product perhaps more one-dimensional.
Mm. Where's the first bike invented?
The first,
you got me thinking.
The first bicycle?
Yeah, because your main designer is in Finland. Now,
I think, I believe the first bicycle is in England, but
all right.
I'm not sure.
That sounds right.
You'd have to Wikipedia that.
Okay, all right. Well, I understand that your company also does a lot of kind of promoting loving the environment, you know, energy saving, that kind of stuff. So I guess the company also does a lot of charity work. So you want to talk a little bit about that? Things that you've been doing, TURN and
sure.
Taiwan's yeah. environment?
Well, 1% of our profits will go to either environmental or social causes. We're not profitable yet. So we haven't given too much, but we have done a number of things. I think, recently, you know, at every trade show, we'll run kind of a donation campaign. So in Las Vegas, just last month, we raised money for the Alliance for Biking and Walking.
Okay.
So we had some nice stainless steel pint glasses. We had some great New Belgium beer. And if you made a $5 donation to the Alliance for Biking and Walking.
Five NT?
$5.
Oh, US dollars.
US dollars.
Okay.
you would get a great glass of beer. So the Alliance for Biking and Walking is an organization that promotes healthier, more sustainable, more livable cities by advocating for more walking and biking space.
I'm sorry, this alliance is a US-based
yes.
alliance. Oh,
yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Got it.
That's US. So that, but we do that sort of thing in, you know, in lots of different,
mm-hmm.
We'll find a good, an organization that we believe in, and we will support them with money. So I think we raised, I don't remember, $1,000, $2,000
mm-hmm.
for them, just in a few hours.
Yeah, so. All right. So, yeah, I think you just reminded me. Let's talk about urban biking here
mm-hmm.
in Taiwan. Would you say urban biking has become like a trend in the last, oh, I don't know, 10 years? Longer than that? No?
In Taiwan.
Yeah, in Taiwan.
I think I would say less than 10 years.
Less than, huh?
I would say five or six.
Yeah, not quite. Yeah, it's amazing how it's really grown.
Yeah.
So obviously, this is a great asset for your business. So how are you seeing this trend that's happening here in Taiwan?
Well, I think it's fantastic to see because, you know, I moved to Taiwan 20 years ago. 20 years ago, at 6 o'clock, you had gridlock everywhere. You had terrible air pollution. Nobody bicycled.
Yeah.
Everybody was on a scooter. And it was a traffic nightmare, especially if it rained a little bit, right? And if you look at Taipei today, it's amazing. You know, when you leave the house at 6, you just say, oh, I need 10 more minutes. Maybe traffic is a little heavier. But, you know, everybody's using the MRT.
Yeah.
And if you go out to the bike paths on weekends, you see traffic jams.
Oh, yeah.
Of cyclists.
Yes.
And that wasn't the case 5, 6 years ago. So I think what we've seen is Taipei actually invest money in infrastructure, in mass transportation, and I think we can see the benefits. They're very clear benefits. The air has gotten much better.
Okay. Well, good thing you noticed it. Yeah, you think, yeah. But you're probably right.
You know, just even yesterday along the bike path, you know, we see a lot of investment in cycle paths. I think the investment for recreational cycling has been fantastic. I think now we need to see some real investment in Taipei City.
Yeah.
You know, the bike path that was on Dunhua was, let's say, not terribly well conceived.
Yeah, I know, because, you know, it's right by the car lanes and then the bus lanes. And
the taxis use
there, it. Yeah, yeah. It wasn't ideal.
But on the other hand, last week I saw a new bike path along Xinyi. You know, Taipei as a city is really not very big.
No.
Right, to ride from Heping to Minquan across town would take 10 or 15 minutes if you had a good bike path.
Okay, well that's great. Yeah. Yes, I know, you know, with the convenience of U-bike these days,
yes.
It really is great. I mean, you see people actually paying the U-bike and just to cycle around a park.
Yes.
That's what I saw last night.
Yeah.
And I think, well, because it's so cheap,
yes,
you know, renting the bike, but they're doing that. You need your own bike, but you get to exercise by biking around, renting those bikes. So.
Yeah, we saw tons of U-bikes. I think, you know, we really have to recognize Giant for really investing in a system and doing a great job with it.
Yes, I agree.
It's fantastic. We're also members and users.
Yeah,
and it's
really
fantastic. Yeah.
Okay. Well, that's great. Well, what do you foresee urban biking and turn in the future? What's in your head now that you're thinking of developing and making turn better and better, turn bikes?
There's a lot still to be done to develop. I mean, there's been so much technology put into racing bikes.
So, is that your direction? The direction that you're taking, racing bikes?
No, not at all.
Okay.
So there has been so much development by the industry into racing bikes, making them lighter and faster. But the amount of development for bikes that are designed for urban and city use is relatively small, I would
say.
And there's so much room to create better technology, newer products, bikes that ride better, bikes that are more comfortable, bikes that are safer.
For different ages.
Yes.
For different sizes.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
And so we're working on all of those things. So
right.
Whether it's integrated lighting, or carrying more cargo so that you can do a week's worth of grocery shopping by bicycle.
Yeah.
These are all things we're working on.
Okay, well, that's great.
Yeah.
Well, hey, I mean, what's this, if it weren't for you to show us your bikes and demonstrate just how actually a bike folds and unfolds.
Okay.
Okay, so let's take a look.
Yeah, sure. All right.
All right, Josh, you want to kind of introduce us to the first model right here?
Sure. Well, we've got a couple of different types of bikes for different types of consumers. This bike has a very low step frame. You can see this. And so this is designed for the consumer, maybe who's a little bit older, maybe who's wearing a skirt or a dress. But the idea is that no matter what your physical condition, no matter how you're dressed, you should be able to ride a bike for urban usage.
Okay.
And so that's what, that's the type of customer this bike is designed for.
All right.
Next we have this bike, it's called the Node. This is a new model for us this year. And this is a full-sized folding bike.
Oh, all right, full size. Because that means the wheels are the normal size bike wheels, right?
Yes.
Okay,
All right. Typically when people say folding bicycle, you think of very small wheels.
Yeah, like that one.
Rickety riding performance, not like this one.
Okay.
Something that doesn't ride well and is very compromised in terms of riding. This bike is not any of these. It rides exactly like a full-sized bicycle, but it also folds for convenience.
Mm. What kind of people would like to buy this kind of bike?
Anybody who's riding around in the city, doing errands, getting to work,
really?
Getting things done. You can see that it has weather protection, it can accept racks front and rear.
Oh, yeah.
It has a dynamo hub with integrated lighting. There are so many features on this that are really designed for daily use in the city.
All right. Is there a bell? Well, you can have a bell, right?
It comes with a bell.
Oh, it comes with a bell.
It's not on the center.
All right, okay. Yep. What about this next one?
Well, this next one is one of my favorites. I happen to think it looks pretty good.
Yeah.
These are cork, real cork grips.
That's what I thought. It looked like cork.
Yes, it's real cork.
What's the benefit of a cork material handle?
Well, this cork, I believe it's 40% of the by weight is from a renewable resource. So it's harvested. I think it's either Portugal or Spain. Renewable. It also looks pretty good.
Yeah.
And it also has a bit of a cushioning effect, which is nice.
Okay. Does it absorb sweat?
No, it doesn't.
Oh, just asking.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
All right.
One of the interesting features on this bike is that it has a dynamo hub. So you can see this is our dynamo hub, which is the smallest, lightest dynamo hub on the market.
Uh-huh.
And what it does is it has integrated with magnets. And so when you spin the wheel, it generates electricity.
Oh, cool.
So if you take a look at this integrated light here,
yep.
When I turn the wheel,
there you go.
The light turns on. And so that means that you don't need a battery-powered light, you're throwing out batteries every week. It means when you ride, you automatically have lighting and you're safe riding at night.
That's great.
Yep.
All right. And this next one,
This is
smart looking.
This is my personal favorite. This is the bike I'm riding right now.
Oh, and this color?
Yes.
Okay.
So this is an extremely light, extremely fast bike that folds.
All right.
Again, this is hitting the stereotype of, folding bikes, small wheels, don't ride well, they're rickety. And this bike breaks all of those stereotypes.
Uh-huh.
It's light, it's extremely fast, but it folds in 10 seconds so that you can throw it into your car or take it on the MRT.
Okay, so you're going to demonstrate 10 seconds folding this bike right here, right?
Sure.
10 seconds, I'm going to time you. Anyway.
So this is another bike, it's called the Verge X10. It basically folds in three easy steps.
Really?
So, yeah, I'll show you.
Okay.
So, one, two, three. So,
that's it.
Yeah.
And you'll carry it. You lock it.
You strap it here.
Okay. Yeah. There you go.
Yeah. So that goes easily into the car, onto the subway. We have various bags to let you carry it. But it's a very nice package. And, you know, when you riding it, it's extremely fast. It's extremely light.
Mm-hmm.
But it's so convenient.
All right.
Yeah.
Now you want to demonstrate unfolding it?
Sure. So you just reverse the steps, and it's actually...
That was even faster.
Yeah, a little bit less than 10 seconds.
Wow, that is great.
Yep.
Well, thank you so very much, Josh.
Thanks, Shirley.
This has been really fun.
Yes.
And good luck with this business. I mean, these are great. They're smart looking bikes. They're really great.
Thank you very much. We work hard.
All right, great.
Thanks.
Thank you for watching, people. I'm Shirley Lin.